So today we'll take up the 21st session on chapter on relative velocity. So in this we will discuss the concept of relative acceleration between two moving points P1 and P2 as seen from a particular reference frame F. Okay. So we define this quantity first. Definition of relative acceleration between two moving points as seen from some given reference frame F. Definition of relative acceleration between two moving points P1 and P2. Two moving points P1 and P2 in some given reference frame F. So first we'll define it, okay? So, this is how the definition goes. Suppose this is some given reference frame F. P1 and P2 are two moving points as seen from frame F. At a certain instant of time, acceleration of point P1 with respect to frame F at time t is, say, A1F. Okay? So, A1F is the acceleration of point P1 with respect to frame F at certain instant t, and acceleration of point P2 with respect to same frame F at some given time t is A2F. Okay, so, and one more thing, suppose the velocity of P1 with respect to F at certain instant is V1F. So this should be clear that in general for a moving point its velocity and acceleration do not have the same direction. This has already been discussed in the previous videos on particle kinematics, okay? And similarly, suppose the velocity of P2 with respect to F is V2F at time t, okay? So this is the situation at time t. Now what we do, we first define the concept of relative acceleration between these two moving points in frame F. So we write it in this way. A P2 P1 slash F. This means acceleration of point P2 with respect to point P1 in frame F. Of point P2 with respect to WRT, meaning with respect to point P1 in frame F at time t. Just now we discussed in frame F is of very crucial importance. This we have to mention. So this is defined to be A2F minus A1F. A2F, A1F has the same meaning as discussed, stated just now. Okay, fine. So AP2, P1F is the acceleration of point P2 with respect to point P1 in frame F at time t. That is equal to A2F minus A1F. Is the vector difference of A2F and A1F. As we know from the theory on chapter on vectors, this term can be written as A2F plus minus of A1F. Minus of A1F meaning reverse of A1F. Okay, so this quantity minus A1F is nothing but the reverse of vector A1F. It is nothing but the reverse of vector A1F. So this is how the acceleration or relative acceleration between two moving points is defined. So one thing I would like to make it very clear that in frame F is of very crucial importance. In frame F, generally when one appears in after passing 10th examination, when our student goes in 11th, 12th, then is in the or usual books on relative velocity or introductory books on relative velocity, in frame F is not mentioned. But this is of vital importance. See, without defining the frame, relative acceleration between two moving points has no meaning. Okay. So first we'll discuss this in frame F clause, we'll discuss just now, and then we'll proceed ahead. Fine. See, this in frame F is of very crucial importance. I will explain it by means of an example. Okay. So this I'll draw it. Okay. I will explain this by means of an example. Suppose we have two frames, one say ground frame and one says some other frame. Okay, fine. Just to illustrate this concept, okay. I'll wrap this also, fine. So this is how it goes. So first I'll explain the meaning of the clause in frame F. That will make it very clear. Okay. So for this I'll take an example and then explain it. See, suppose instead of F we have say ground frame. Okay. And ground frame is being denoted by G. And suppose we have some other frame, say M frame. Okay. Say a rod, a rigid rod. So we take some other frame, say R. R for rod. Okay. Now see, I will take an example and illustrate this concept. See, this is how it goes. Suppose this is the ground frame, right? This is a rod. R denotes a rod, a rigid body. Suppose the lower end of the rod is pivoted. This is pivoted flexibly. It can rotate about this point with respect to ground. Okay. This is a pivot. This is the pivot. This is the pivot of the rod. Okay. Lower end of the rod is fixed at this point, and the rod can rotate about this point with respect to ground frame. Suppose we take two moving points P1 and P2. Two material points P1 and P2 of this rod. P1 and P2 are the two material points of this rod. Fine. See, instead of rod, we denote R. R means frame of rod. And G means ground frame. Fine. Suppose the rod is rotating. So let us make one more assumption. Suppose point P1 is at a distance of say 1 meter from the pivot. And P2 is at a distance of say 3 meter from the pivot. Suppose the rod is rotating at a constant angular speed omega with respect to ground. Say 40 radian per second. Okay. Let's make it a smaller. Now take 40, let's just make it 4. Just to minimize the calculations, okay. So omega is taken to be 4 radian per second. This is the constant angular speed of rod with respect to ground. See, P1 and P2 are the material points of this rod, okay. So acceleration of P1 with respect to rod, AP1R, that is 0. Because P1 is a material point of the rod. As seen from rod, P1 is always fixed. So therefore, its acceleration with respect to rod is always 0. Similarly, P2 is also a material point of this rod. So AP2R, that is also 0. Because P2 is a material point of the rod. It is fixed with respect to rod. So its acceleration with respect to rod is always 0. So these two are 0 for all times. This means acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in rod frame, AP2 P1R, by definition of relative acceleration between two points, this will be equal to AP2R minus AP1R. This will be vector 0 minus vector 0, any 0 for all times. So this means relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in rod frame is 0 for all times. Now let us take the case of ground frame, okay. Suppose this rod is taken to be the y-axis. Suppose we take the origin at the upper end of the rod. And we take this direction to be the y-direction. So at this instant, this coordinate system is assumed to be fixed with respect to ground, okay? O to y, this coordinate system is fixed in ground, and rod coincides with this y-axis at this instant. So this coordinate system is fixed with respect to ground, and rod coincides with this y-axis at this instant. Fine. Now see, as seen from ground frame, P2 moves in a circular path whose center is at this point and radius is 3 meter. And it's a uniform circular motion because omega is constant. So acceleration of P2 with respect to ground frame becomes omega square into radius from the theory of uniform circular motion. A point revolving in a circle with constant angular speed, its acceleration is equal to omega square into radius directed towards center of the circle. So as seen from ground, P2 moves in a circle whose center is at this pivot and whose radius is 3 meter. And angular speed of circular motion is omega, 4 radian per second. So acceleration of P2 with respect to ground will become omega square, 4 square into radius, that is 3, in downward direction, that is along positive y axis, j hat. So this becomes, 4 square becomes 16 into 3, 48. 48 j hat meter per second square. And what about AP1G? AP1G can also be evaluated in a similar way. Point P1 undergoes a uniform circular motion with respect to ground, whose center is at pivot and radius is 1 meter, and omega is 4 radian per second. So AP1G becomes omega square r, so 4 square into radius of this circular motion of P1 with respect to ground is 1 meter, 1 into j hat. This becomes 16 j hat meter per second square. Now we take the difference. AP2G minus AP1G, that becomes 48 j hat minus 16 j hat, that is just equal to 32 j hat meter per second square. And this you can see, this is not equal to AP2P1R. See, this is different from AP2P1R. So what does this mean? This means relative acceleration between P2 and P1 in ground frame, AP2P1G, is not equal to AP2P1R. So this means, if you only write this much, acceleration of P2 with respect to P1, do you think will it make any meaning? Will it have any sense? It will be useless. Because in different frames, this has a different quantity. In rod frame, this is AP2P1R is a zero vector. In ground frame, AP2P1G is a non-zero vector. If you take some other reference frame, some say rotating Disneyland, from there we observe the relative acceleration between these two points. Again, it will turn out to be some other value, different from this 32J, different from 0, some other value. So this means that unless and until we specify the name of the reference frame, AP2P1F has no meaning. So in frame F is very crucial. Without specifying that frame F, if we only write AP2P1, acceleration of P2 with respect to P1, then it becomes meaningless. I hope it is clear what I have said just now. Okay, fine. So this means that whenever we talk of relative acceleration between two points, we have to specify the name of the reference frame, in which frame we are evaluating those two accelerations. Okay, fine. So this one thing I have told, I hope it is clear. Without specifying the name of frame, AP2P1, simply if you write AP2P1, then that has no meaning. Fine. If you only write AP2P1, then it is meaningless concept. So we have to specify the name of the reference frame. Fine. So as I have told just now, I am repeating it once again. If we view these two points from some other rotating frame, say this rotating Disneyland frame, a rotating fan frame, from there if you evaluate AP2F minus AP1F, it will turn out to be some other value other than 0, other than 32J, some other value. So it becomes, so without specifying the name of the frame, AP2P1F has no meaning, it has a meaningless term. Fine? Okay? So I'll grab it, okay? See, one more thing I'd just like to mention. So, if you take the general case, we take the general case, suppose we take two frames M and F. Suppose we take two reference frames F and M, okay, and P1 and P2 are two moving points. In general, they are moving with respect to M and F both. Then suppose M rotates with respect to F. If M rotates with respect to F, then just as we discussed just now, AP2P1F will not be equal to AP2P1M. Because as we just took the case of that rod frame, rod was rotating with respect to ground. There we observed that the relative acceleration between P2 and P1 in ground frame and relative acceleration between P2 and P1 in rod frame, they are not the same. They are different. So rod was rotating with respect to ground. So in that case, M is here rotating with respect to F, general case. Here also these two will not be equal in general. They will be different. Relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F is not equal to relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in M frame. Okay. But there is one special case. If M translates with respect to F, then relative acceleration between these two points in F and M will be equal. So this is of great importance. So relative acceleration between two points is same in all frames which are in mutual translation. Fine. This is how I explained it just now. Okay. Relative acceleration between two points is same in all frames which are in mutual translation. Between two points, between two points, between two points, P1 and P2 is same in all frames which are in mutual translation. Is same in all frames which are in mutual translation. Which are in mutual what? Translation. So relative acceleration between two points P1 and P2 is same in all frames which are in mutual translation. This can be understood in this way. See, like this. Suppose M translates with respect to F. M is a reference plane which translates with respect to F. M translates with respect to F, WRT. As we discussed in the 13th video on relative velocity chapter, that if M translates with respect to F, in that case, acceleration of a moving point P with respect to frame F is related to APM in this way. APF equal to APM plus AMF. This follows from the 13th video on relative velocity, whose link will be given in the description box of this 21st video. So from the theory on relative acceleration between two translating frames, this was discussed in 13th video. So APF is equal to APM plus AMF. This is valid whenever M translates with respect to F. Now, instead of P, we take two points, P2 and P1. Okay. If we take the P2 to be P, then this will imply that AP2F becomes AP2M plus AMF. And similarly, instead of P1, we take P1 to be point P, then this will also imply AP1F is equal to AP1M plus AMF. So this is first relation and this is the second relation. Now we take the vector difference, first minus second. first minus second equation, if you take the difference, then what do we get? AP2F minus AP1F is equal to AP2M plus AMF minus AP1M plus AMF. Now, this quantity we know is nothing but the relative acceleration between P2 and P1 in frame F. So, this will be written as AP2P1/frame F. And these two terms will cancel out. Right side we get AP2M minus AP1M. That is nothing but the relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame M. So this means this is the relation which is true for all times. So this is just the statement which I have just now mentioned just now. Relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F is equal to relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F for all times. So this means relative acceleration between two points P1 and P2 is same in all frames which are in mutual translation. I hope it is clear what I have said. So relative acceleration between two moving points P1 and P2 is same in all frames which are in mutual translation. So this result should be remembered. It is a very important result. It is a basic concept. It should be very understood clear. It should be understood very clearly. Fine. So relative acceleration between P2 and P1 in frame F is equal to relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame M, where M translates with respect to F. So these two relative accelerations in these two frames are always equal. Fine. Is it clear? I think it's clear what I have said just now. Fine. So this one thing I have explained fully. Now I'll web it, okay? So I'm repeatedly telling, we talked this about this translating frame theory in 13th video. So you can go to the 13th video, whose description link has been given in the description box of this video, and you can refer to that video and see all the details. All the details are fully there, okay? Now we'll talk one more thing. See, now we'll again take the general case, okay? Suppose we are given a frame F. Suppose we are given some frame F. F is some frame. P2 and P1 are two moving points with respect to F. As I talked just now in the beginning of this video, P1 and P2 have accelerations A1F, A2F, etc. Say, A2F say with respect to frame F at time t. P1 has a velocity V1F with respect to F at time t. P2 has velocity V2F with respect to F at time t. These velocities have been shown arbitrary way. And just now, as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, in general, acceleration and velocities do not have the same direction. Okay. Now we know that A2F is acceleration of P2 with respect to frame F at time t. That is nothing but the derivative of the velocity V2F with respect to time as seen from frame F. This also has been fully discussed in the previous videos. You can go and see any of those, okay? And all the links for the remaining videos have also been given in the description box of this video, okay? And similarly, A1F is nothing but the acceleration of P1 with respect to frame F at time t. That is nothing but the derivative of velocity vector Vt V1F by dt in frame F. Now, we take the difference, this minus this. If we take the difference, then what do we get? This minus this, this equation minus this equation. So we get A2F minus A1F is equal to dV2F by dt in frame F minus dV1F by dt in what? frame F. This quantity we know is nothing but the relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F. And here d by dt is a common term. Derivative of difference equal to difference in derivatives. So difference in derivative is equal to derivative of difference. V2F minus V1F in frame F. So A P2 P1 F becomes d by dt of V2F minus V1F is nothing but the relative velocity of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F. And we derivate this in frame F. Just to simplify the notation, we denote this quantity by A relative. And just to simplify the notation, we denote this quantity by V relative. So this we write as d of V relative by dt in frame F. So this is a result of great importance. So relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F is the time derivative of relative velocity of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F differentiated with respect to frame F. If we denote this quantity by A relative, just for shortening the notation, this quantity as V relative, the relative acceleration between two points P1 and P2 in frame F is the time derivative of relative velocity between these two points in frame F. So this result is of great significance. Fine. Now, if you take one more case, this equation is valid for all times. If we now assume if A relative is 0 for all times, what does this imply? This means dV relative by dt in frame F is 0 for all times. This means that V relative is constant. This means velocity of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F is constant. This means P1 will observe that P2 moves in a straight line at a constant relative speed of V relative. This is a result of great importance. In the coming videos on relative velocity, we'll discuss many numericals which are based on this concept. For example, relative velocity collision problems, relative velocity shortest distance problems. This result is used very frequently in the relative velocity problems. Fine. So, this means that if A relative is 0 between two moving points for all instants, then the relative velocity between these two points in frame F is also constant. Relative acceleration is 0. I'll repeat it once again. If relative acceleration between two moving points is 0 always in frame F, this means that the relative velocity of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F is also constant. That is, P1 will observe that P2 moves with a constant relative velocity V relative. That is, P1 will observe that P2 moves in a straight path at a constant relative speed of V relative. The V relative is the magnitude of this quantity, any magnitude of this quantity. Fine. So this result is of great importance. So I am repeating it again and again, I am emphasizing its importance, that whenever relative acceleration between two moving points is zero, that means the relative velocity between these two points is also constant. That will mean that one point will observe that other point moves in a straight path at a constant relative speed of V relative. Okay, fine. So I'll rub it now. Last point, I would say one more thing. See, A P2 P1 F by definition is the relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F, which we write as A2 F minus A1 F. Similarly, A P1 P2 F is the relative acceleration of P1 with respect to P2 in frame F, which we write as A1F minus A2F. From these two equations, it is seen that if you add these two, on right hand side, these two terms cancel out, four terms. So these two equations implies that AP2P1F plus AP1P2F, that becomes this plus this. These two go away, these two goes away. The right side becomes 0. This means A P1 P2 F is just the reverse of A P2 P1 F. This means the relative acceleration of P1 with respect to P2 in frame F is opposite of the relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F. This means both these relative accelerations will have the same magnitude but in opposite direction. So this means from the theory of vector that A P2 P1 F and A P2 P1 F have equal magnitudes but opposite direction. Have equal magnitudes but opposite directions. This means that if P1 observes that P2 is accelerating towards north at 5 meter per second square, then P2 will observe that P1 is accelerating towards south at 5 meter per second square. This is what it means. These two have the same magnitude but opposite directions. That is, relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F has same magnitude as relative acceleration of P1 with respect to P2 in frame F, and they are opposite in direction. This point also has to be taken into account. This frequently comes in the numericals on physics. Okay. So, in this 21st session on relative velocity, the concept of relative acceleration between two moving points has been fully discussed. Okay. Original definition has been given. Importance of in-frame F has been emphasized. Why relative acceleration between two moving points is different in different frames. Example, if you took the rod frame, rotating rod frame. And then it was shown that if M translates with respect to F, then relative acceleration between two moving points in these two frames are always equal. That is, relative acceleration between two moving points is same in all frames which are in mutual translation. And one more thing we will discuss, that relative acceleration is the derivative of relative velocity. And one more thing we will state, that if A relative is zero for all instants, then relative velocity becomes constant. So one point will observe that other point moves in a straight path at a constant relative speed of V relative. And last point, I told that the relative acceleration of P2 with respect to P1 in frame F and P1 with respect to P2 in frame F have equal magnitude but opposite directions. So this is all about the 21st video. I suppose whatever I have said, is it clear? If you have any doubt, you go through the video again and again. All your doubts will be fully cleared. Okay. In the next video, what we'll do, we'll take up the calculation of relative acceleration between two moving points in the 22nd video. This was the 21st video. On the 22nd video, we take up the calculation of relative acceleration between two moving points in some given frame. Generally, that frame is ground frame. Generally, most of the cases, F is nothing but the ground frame. Okay, so we close it here now. Okay.